Yo, what's good, what's going on, people? How's everybody doing today? It's, what's today, Tuesday? It's Tuesday, April 16th, I think. We're about to do some NFL news. We about to do that shit. We about to do our thing. What's going on? I am going live on TikTok. Yes, I got to go live on TikTok right now. That is the plan of attack. I got to go live on TikTok. That's what I'm trying to do at the moment. Go live. Yeah, okay. So I'm going live on TikTok. We are live on TikTok. We are live on Twitch. What's going on, people? What's up? We're going to be going through some news, you know, the good old news. And, we're gonna go through some news. That's what we're gonna do. I just ordered some freaking, I ordered these glasses last night. I was like, I want some glasses, and these were the cheapest ones I could find on Amazon. So, I got some glasses. Oh, bro. This stupid sign, dude, I ordered. What's going on, TikTok people? What's up? What's good? We're doing NFL news. We're gonna go through some NFL news. Head on over to Twitch if you wanna get a better view. Head on over to Twitch, at Tico Fantasy Show. Much better view over there. And, what was that? But, dude, so I got this sign, right? I got this sign, this Tico Fantasy Show sign, and I thought it was going to be way bigger. It is so fucking tiny. It is just a little tiny sign. It is terrible. It is awful. I thought it was going to be quadruple, four times the size of that. And I spent a lot of money on it, and I'm very irritated, but I was like, fuck it, I got it, I might as well put it up for the moment, let me just throw it on the wall. Why not just throw it on the wall? But I ordered some glasses off Amazon, and I'm gonna look at these glasses real quick. I didn't really care about this pair, I wanted this pair, because my other pair broke, but I needed some new glasses, so I had to cop some, you know, Amazon, cheap. $10, I think I spent on these. And, look at these. These are kind of ball. Oh-ho-ho! Oh-ho-ho! Tell me those ain't baller. Come on, bro. Those are baller as hell. But listen, if you're over on TikTok right now, you need to head on over to Twitch, at Tico Fantasy Show. You need to go over there, follow, get your name on this board behind me, and if you go over there, it's a significantly better view. It looks way better, like the Twitch people will tell you. It looks significantly better over there. So, head on over there, and we're going to be going through the NFL news very shortly. Give me like 2-3 minutes, and we're going to go through some NFL news. That's what we're going to do. In the meantime, you can look at me play with these glasses I just bought. That's what I'm going to be doing in the meantime. But while I wait for you to go on over to Twitch or do yo thing, oh, dude, they're loose. This is loose. It's loose, bruh. I hate when I get glasses and the arms are loose. That shit pisses me off. Oh, but wait! I wonder if this... Is this a screwdriver? It is a screwdriver! It's a screwdriver. They come with a screwdriver, so I guess you can tighten them if they are loose. That's so edumacated, bruh. That's edumacated as hell, bruv. Wait a minute, I can't see. So, I guess if I tighten these, right? I guess I can just tighten this? Oh my god, that is impossible to do. You can't do that. That's impossible. You can't do that. That's not possible. This is not possible. Wait a minute. So you shove it in there. No diddy. Nah, it's so tight. It's so tight, bro. There's no way you can twist that bitch. There's no way. This is like tight as hell, bro. Oh my goodness. You gotta be a freaking master craftsman to do this shit. Is there another one? Is there a smaller one? Oh my god, it's got two! It's got two, brother. Look at that. It's got two. It's like freaking... I don't even know, bro. God, look at me. I'm getting hyped over... this fucking stupid screwdriver. But, yeah, we're about to get into some NFL news, ladies and gentlemen. Head on over to Twitch, at Tico Fantasy Show. Follow, get your name on the board behind me. And we're gonna get into the news, probably right now, actually. Once I put all this fucking garbage away. Throw it in the trash can. Put my glasses on. Oh, actually, wait, where are the red ones? I like the red ones better. The red ones are kind of baller. Oh, whoa. Well, you know what I didn't think about with the red ones? It makes everything red. Like, like when I'm looking, like, I don't know what they look like on screen, but everything is red. I'm an idiot. Why did I not think that was not going to be red? Oh my God, I'm a dingus. Okay, well, let's get into the news. Let's get into the news. I'm wasting time. Let me pull the news up. Let's get that going. Let's do that thing. And yeah, let's do it. Let me go over here, go over there, do a little bit of that. Okay, news time, 4:30 every day we do the news. We do the news every day at 4:30, every day. Okay, let's see what we got going on over here. Let me update this. Let's update this, because I see that we're getting some new shit. Okay, so, who's Trent Taylor? Does anybody know who Trent Taylor is? I don't know. Trent Taylor and the San Francisco 49ers have agreed to terms on a contract. Standout punt returner and receiver Trent Taylor is signing with the Niners. I don't know Trent Taylor. But yeah, Trent Taylor just signed a new deal, or an old new deal? I don't quite know. He's just signed with the Niners, though. It looks like he was already on the Niners, because they got plenty of pictures of him there. But I thought their punt returner was Ronnie Bell. Does Ronnie Bell not do returns for the Niners? Who usually does their returns? I thought it was Ronnie Bell. Oh, well, Trent Taylor. Hey, he got a mustache. We like that. And listen, people on TikTok, if you want to see what the hell I'm looking at right now, I got me like this right here, the news on this side of the screen, but it's on Twitch. You got to go over to Twitch if you want to see it. You got to go over to Twitch. Ray Ray. It was Ray McLeod. That's so true. Yeah, that's actually, you're right. That's what I remember. I thought it was Ronnie Bell. I don't know why. I love Ronnie Bell, though. Ronnie Bell's a G. Love that guy. Max Crosby wants to be a legend. Let's see what Max Crosby has to say.
How do you find the balance, Max, in the day-to-day and all the things?
Max Crosby be talking.
As a foundation, being a father, training. Like,
that's a dope chain. That's a dope chain. Oh, look, it's got like little green beads in it. That shit's dope.
There really isn't balance in this, in the world that I live in. Right now,
Bro, they got him mic'd up terribly. Awful audio. Okay, I'm not listening to this. I'm not listening to this for 2 minutes. This audio's terrible. So Max Crosby said, I'm obsessed. I have all the energy and time in the world because, number one, I'm sober. I chase fucking greatness every single way of my life. I want to be a legend. That's what Max Crosby said. Word for word. That's what he said. W. Max Crosby. Him and Christian Wilkins are going to be gross. Maybe they could get frickin', what's his face? What's Long Arm's name? What's Long Arm's that they drafted last year? Something with a T. I can't think of his name. Yo, who's the edge rusher the Raiders drafted last year? Tyree Wilson. Oh, shit. Wait 1 minute. I forgot. I always forget to change the name of the stream on Twitch, bro. I forget to do this every day. Wait. NFL News. What's today's date? 4/16. I forget to do that every day, bro. Freaking people are... It says WNBA Draft. WNBA Draft was sick last night. We watched that. That shit was sick. It was nice. It was cool. But go over to Twitch, at Tico Fantasy Show. Follow, get your name on the board, and much better view over there. What is this? SportsCenter special today with Adam Schefter, Mel Kiper. Okay, nobody cares. I'm plugging ESPN right now. Back in it, believe people. Damn, I got to start watching soccer, bro. But there's just so many different leagues for soccer. I just don't really like it that much. It's really not that enjoyable, in my opinion. Sorry. We got some people. Oh, some Browns retired. Oh, that doesn't sound good. Well, they're Cleveland Browns players retired. Christian Kirksey. And who is this? I don't know who this is. Who is this? I don't know. Higgins. Is it Rashard Higgins? I don't know. But some Cleveland Browns players retired. Yeah, some Cleveland Browns players retired. Let's keep going here, though. Heartwarming. Cardinals linebacker Jesse Lukita went to Nigeria to provide 150 orphans with food, clothing, and footballs. W-mans.
Toys.
W-mans.
Clothes. And a few bags, so it's gonna be a
whole. I wanna go to Nigeria. Shit looks
My name
like,
is Jesse Luke.
I'd love to go there.
A bunch of gifts, because I know you guys are excited to leave us.
Wearing a Cameron Wake jersey.
It's a great opportunity for us to be here, give back to the community. We're so excited to spend the time with you guys and make sure you guys leave with a whole.
Bro, NFL, hit me up, bro. The NFL's gotta hit me up. All happily, I'd love to go to Africa and give out some footballs, bro. That sounds dope. That sounds dope as hell. I'd love to do that. That freaking sounds sick. What's good, what's good, what's good, people? But head on over to Twitch. Head on over to Twitch if you want. Head on over to Twitch, at Tico Fantasy Show. Better view, and you can see what I'm reading. Definitely the place you want to be. Texans QB CJ Stroud is throwing a baseball! Okay, I don't really give a shit. I mean, throwing a baseball, cool. Don't throw out your arm, buddy. Browns QB Deshaun Watson has shoulder told reporters today he's now throwing at full speed. Throwing full speed interceptions. Throwing full speed, getting full speed massages. Getting the full speed rub and tug. Kansas City and the Philadelphia Eagles were two teams that showed the most interest in Jason Kelce on draft night. This is not news. This is like terrible news. Oh, this is cool though. This is what they think the new Lions jerseys are going to look like. This is one of the alleged Lions jerseys. They think they're going to have a new black design, like this black jersey with the blue lettering, which would be pretty sick. Not going to lie, that'd be a pretty sick jersey if they did that. I wouldn't mind that. I like that. I like that, bruh. I like that. That'd be pretty sick. But then again, it's not confirmed or anything. It's just this guy did a graphic for it. It's not anything real yet. We don't know. But Denver Broncos' Cortland Sutton is not attending voluntary workouts because he is seeking a new contract. I wonder what's going to happen with that. What's his contract look like? Does he have 1 year left on it? Let's look real quick. Let's look at Cortland Sutton's contract real quick. Cortland Sutton contract. Let's look at this real quick. Let's break this down. Let's look at this, John. Cortland Sutton is under contract for 2 more years? Why does he want a new contract? What is he holding out for? He's still under contract for 2024 and 2026. What the fuck, Cortland Sutton? I thought you only had 1 year left, and that's why you were being a bitch about it. Not because you have two. Dude, you're freaking 30 years old. You're 29 years old. You're about to be 29 years old. And you're bitching about... You have 2 years left on your deal, and you're bitching about getting a new deal? What? What? Come on, Cortland Sutton. I expect more from you than that. That's stupid. There's zero reason for you to be complaining about talking about getting a new contract. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Not the right time for that, buddy. Not the right time. You've still got 2 years left. I don't even know, like... If they're going to give you an extension, like, that might come, like, not next year. That might even come when your 2 years are done. They might not even make you an offer at that point. Like, that's silly. That's silly. I'm sorry. Sorry, Cortland Sutton. But you shouldn't be fighting for a contract right now. That's silly. Holy shit! South Carolina receiver Xavier Leggett looks extremely impressive as he is preparing for the NFL draft. Xavier Leggett continues to rise up many teams' boards and is pushing to be a first rounder. I doubt it. I doubt it. Dude's big. That looks like Florida. Oh no, what, you know what? That probably is. That's probably South Carolina. That probably sounds crazy, dude. TikTok people hearing these noises, that probably sounds wild.
Run. Play test. There you go.
Okay, I mean, Xavier Leggett looks good. I'm not like, okay, he looks fine. I mean, he doesn't look great. He looks like Xavier Leggett. He doesn't look like anything like, I don't know, man. He was just so terrible at the combine. He had a really bad combine. I know that's like not something you should be judging people off of that much. Like, I know it's not the judgiest thing, but I like to judge people off the combine. I think the combine's a good indicator of future NFL success, at least for receivers. Maybe not other positions, but receivers, I think it's a good indicator. And Xavier Leggett was pretty mid at the combine, not gonna lie. But let's see what chat's saying. Let's see what the chat's saying. Let's see what the chat's saying. Let's see what they're saying on Twitch. Yo, somebody came over from TikTok. Listen, people on TikTok, go over to Twitch at Tico Fantasy Show. Go over to Twitch at Tico Fantasy Show. Way better view, way better way to watch this. Trust me, that's where you want to be. Go over there at Tico Fantasy Show on Twitch. Let's see. Close to being one. Are you a mod? Javon Baker is my sleeper. Dude, everybody wants to be mod. But he's in the server. Do you think the Vikings will get compensated when will I become? I don't know, brother. I don't know. I haven't made that decision yet. I haven't made that decision yet, my brother, my friend. I don't know. Maybe tomorrow, maybe a week, maybe a month, maybe a year. I don't know. I haven't decided yet. I'm just doing NFL news, brother. That's all. I'm just here doing, talking about all the NFL news. That's all. We're just very simple. That's it. Let's keep going with the news. Browns running back Nick Chubb's knee attacking rehab every day, says coach Kevin Stefanski. And then there's going to be another thing later on in this that says there's a possibility Nick Chubb's not going to be back till November. It's possible. I mean, that was a bad injury. That was a very, very, very bad injury he had. So, I don't know, man. I do not know. I do not know. Nick Chubb's going through it. That's all I do know. Nick Chubb has got one hell of a recovery. And even when he does recover, the odds of him being, like really recovered are not very high. Are not very high at all. Browns coach Kevin Stefanski is not sure. Dude, this makes even less sense to me. This makes no sense. This makes no sense. Why? Why would the Browns sign Nyheim Hines? Why would you sign Nyheim Hines? He is still, this is what they said, this is the quote. Browns coach Kevin Stefanski is not sure when new running back Nyheim Hines, ACL, will be ready to practice. Why would you sign somebody coming off an ACL tear when you have Nick Chubb already on the team who's already dealing with a freaking knee that doesn't even exist? Why? Like, I don't get that. That doesn't make any sense to me why you would do that. Eagle Saquon loading. What's he lifting? 90s? God damn. 90s? Sheesh, brother. Sheesh. That's a lot of weight. 90s? Oh my. I can't lift no 90s. I can barely lift 60s. That's crazy. 90s? Well, I mean, he's a football player. What do you expect from the guy, I guess? You know, I guess you expect him to be able to lift like that. Oh, what is it? 24 years ago today? 24 years ago today, Tom Brady got drafted. Tom Brady got drafted. The best late-round draft pick of all time. 24 years ago today. No timetable for Chubb's return. Here are the odds. Here are the odds to be for Brandon Ayuk's next team. Here are the odds for Brandon Ayuk's next team. So right now the Steelers are sitting at number one with 2-1 odds. The Panthers are sitting at 2 with 6-1. I'm not gonna read the actual odds, but the Steelers are the number one team odds wise. The Panthers are number 2 and the Patriots are number 3. Where do you think he ends up? Where do you think he ends up? I think he stays on the Niners. That's what I think. That's what I think. I think he stays on the Niners. I think that's where Brandon Ayuk stays. But listen, if you're on TikTok, head over to Twitch at Tico Fantasy Show. We're going through NFL news. And you can see a much better view over there with the actual news that we're talking about. So head on over there. Trust. Giants. Brandon Ayuk will not be a Giant. I can confirm that much. I know that for a fact. Colts coach Shane Steichen says QB Anthony Richardson is in a really good spot months after his shoulder surgery. That's good. That's good to hear. That's good to hear. We like to hear that. Anthony Richardson. Dude, how high are you drafting Anthony Richardson this year? Where are you drafting Anthony Richardson? What quarterback are you going, is he going off the board as? Like, top 10? Top 15? I don't know. Coming off that shoulder injury, I mean, it's not that severe of an injury for the type of quarterback he is. You know, he uses his legs mostly, so it's not really detrimental. But I don't know. He's going to be somebody you might want to target in the late rounds of your fantasy drafts this year. Just saying. Just saying. Yes, sir. We got the full suit reveal. Yes, sir. You know it. You know it. We got the full suit reveal today. Dude, it was hot as shit today, bro. Florida's hot as hell. Florida is hot as hell, and it's just going to keep getting hotter, bro. Just keeps getting hotter. Summer's getting closer, and it's just getting hotter. Terrible. I hate being hot. Jags QB Trevor Lawrence, who suffered a number of injuries along the 2023 season, told reporters Tuesday that he didn't feel fully healthy until March. I mean, okay. That means he's fully healthy now, at least. This is terrible news, bro. We have awful news today. This is awful. The Miami Dolphins have extension planned for Jalen Waddle. I'd sure like to hope they have an extension plan for him. I mean, shit. What is this grammar? The Miami Dolphins have extension plan for Jalen Waddle. What is this grammar, bruh? News. Raiders wide receiver Davante Adams has said that he is comfortable playing with a rookie quarterback and his favorite QB across prospect is Jaden Daniels. It doesn't matter, bro. I understand that Davante Adams wouldn't mind playing with a rookie quarterback, but there is no chance in hell the Raiders are getting Jaden Daniels. It can't happen. It won't happen, and it can't happen. 110% it can't happen. There's no way Jaden Daniels is going to be a Raider. Jaden Daniels has two options. Jaden Daniels is either a Commander or a Patriot. That's it. No in between. I don't think anybody trades up. I think those three picks, the Bears are picking at one, the Commanders are picking at two, the Patriots are picking at three. That's how I think it goes. No in between. No beating the system. Cowboys owner Jerry Jones confirms that the team is all in on this season, but they need to hold back money to re-sign their star players. We spend max money year in and year out. All 32 can only spend the same amount of money over a five-year stretch. When we're all said and done, we max out our salary cap every year. We will have done that. But what comes with having a good roster, which we do, we're also looking towards signing our own guys. Yeah. Yeah, there's a lot of guys you got to pay. There's a lot of guys the Cowboys got to pay. Cowboys salary table. They got to pay CD. They got to pay Dak. They got to pay Micah. They got to pay... Who else is coming up for an extension? Let's see. Who else? Is there a way to check that? How would I check that? 2025 update... Micah, Trayvon's already getting paid. Brandon Cooks, CD's not under contract next year. Yeah, there's a lot of guys that gotta pay, and a lot of money. They have to give out a lot of money. A lot of money. The Cowboys gotta give out a lot of money. A lot. You gotta pay Micah. You gotta pay Micah. Micah's gonna want freaking... Who just got $30 million a year? Somebody just got a crazy number. Who was it? I don't know. But Micah's going to want at least $30 million a year. CeeDee Lamb's probably going to want $30 million a year. Dak Prescott's going to want $40-something million a year, $50 million a year. There's no way the Cowboys can re-sign Micah Parsons, CeeDee, and Dak Prescott. It's not possible. At least I don't think it is. I don't think there's a possible way for him to sign all three. I don't think there's a way for him to do it because they just don't have enough money. That's a lot of money you got to spend. That's $130, $40 million right there between the three of those guys. I don't think they get it done. I don't think they get all three back. But if you don't get all three back, okay, here's the question. If you can only get two of the three of them back, who do you get? Micah Parsons, CeeDee, and Dak Prescott. What's the two of the three that you bring back? I know my answer easily. Actually, no, I don't. That's a hard question, actually. Micah Parsons, CeeDee, and Dak Prescott, they're all three. Dak Prescott was good last year. Dak Prescott had an MVP season last year. I don't think people remember that. Don't let that fly over your head. Quarterback's the most important position on a football team. Just saying. Dak Prescott was MVP runner-up last year, I believe. I don't know. That's a hard question. Let's see. I love Trey Lance, but I mean, maybe give Trey Lance a chance. I'm fine with it. I'd love to see Trey Lance get a chance. But you know what I'd like even more than seeing Trey Lance get a chance? I'd like to see the people on TikTok go over to Twitch and follow so I can write your name on this board. At Tico Fantasy Show. I know it's backwards, but whatever. I'd probably keep... I'd probably keep CD and Micah over Dak. I know that's so hard to say. But, like, I'd rather... That's hard. Because I don't think you get rid of CD. I think CD's too good and young to get rid of. But Micah's so good. Micah's, like, one of the best... Micah's just a difference maker. The real thing you should try to do is move around your money so that you can get all three to come back. That's what you should try and do. Can they do that? I don't know. But... Let's see, how much money do they have next year? Next year they have $83 million in cap space next year. So that's, let's say Micah takes, no, they don't have enough money to get all three. I don't think they have enough money to bring back all three of these guys. How much money do they have in 2026? $282 million? Maybe. Maybe they have enough money if they restructure their contracts a little differently. Maybe. Chargers head coach Jim Harbaugh is living out his RV... is living out of his RV, and it's awesome.
Are you guys part of the team, or what? Yeah, I am. We all are. Yeah, and I'm coaching for him.
Oh, you are. Have you seen this, bro? Have you seen this, bro? Jim Harbaugh is living in a freaking RV park, which, no, like, not like shaming or anything. It's kind of dope, low-key. Okay,
check this rig out. It's like what the rock bands go around in right here.
I mean, for one person, this beats any hotel room in America. You know what I mean?
Take the words out of my mouth.
Yeah.
RVs, baby. RVs. UNC quarterback Drake May is the quote-unquote preference for the Vikings at quarterback in this draft. Minnesota has been active in trying to trade up for a top pick. I'd like to see Drake May on the Vikings. I like to think Justin Jefferson would like to see Drake May on the Vikings, too. I think everybody would like to see that. I don't know who wouldn't be happy to see Drake May on the Vikings. I mean, Drake May on the Vikings would be kind of gross. Potential Steelers offense. Oh my. Okay, so look what PFF is doing already. They don't even have Justin Fields in there. They got Russell Wilson at quarterback, Najee Harris at running back, Jaylen Warren. They got Brandon Ayuk, George Pickens. Listen to this. Listen to me. Hear me out here. I've been talking about this with my friends for the past, like, forever. I've been talking about this for so long. The idea that nobody has done this yet. I don't know why nobody in the NFL has done this yet. But a QB by committee. Think about that. Think about that for a second. Instead of bringing like an extra tight end out there, an extra wide receiver, you have two quarterbacks on the field. And you know, you line it up where you got one back in the back and you have another quarterback. Like, why has nobody tried that? You don't think like that might work? Like, could that not work? Especially when you have a quarterback like Justin Fields who is super fast and can run. A dual threat quarterback like that? Just saying. I think that'd be pretty sick. I don't know why nobody's tried it yet. I gotta think, like, I don't know. Dual quarterback system. Somebody's gotta figure it out one day. We'll see it. I'll see it in my lifetime. I know we will. At least one team will try it. Hitting me with the, says the Dolphins fan. Okay, let's keep going. Browns QB Deshaun Watson. Nope, I already read that. Texans QB CJ Stroud says he would love to play with top receiver prospect Marvin Harrison Jr. in the NFL. He says he knows it's unlikely, but he's extremely proud of Marvin Harrison Jr., the special player he is. It ain't gonna happen, so I don't even know why even say that. It ain't gonna happen, so let's not even waste time thinking about it. It ain't happen. We're never gonna see Marvin Harrison Jr. and CJ Stroud throw a pass together ever again. I don't even know if we ever did. CJ Stroud. No, yeah, we did. No. Yeah. No, yeah, CJ Stroud played with Marvin Harrison that whole entire last year. What am I talking about? Yeah. This whole entire last year. I'm tripping. The Dolphins plan to pick up the fifth-year options on wide receiver Jalen Waddle and outside linebacker Jalen Phillips. I love to hear that. I love to hear that as a Dolphins fan. I mean, I don't know why they were going to pick up the fifth-year option. I don't know why that's not even a question. They were obviously going to pick up the fifth-year option on the both of them. Not, like, crazy at all. Desperately wanted to know what Mike McDaniel was texting during this draft.
Been waiting all night for this pick. Here we go. All right, so okay. McDaniel's.
People on TikTok, go over to Twitch at Tico Fantasy Show. Follow, get your name on the board, and you get a much better view over there. So Twitch, that's the place to be. Trust. Jalen Phillips probably isn't going to be cleared to play till at least the beginning of the season, if he's lucky. I mean, he tore his Achilles, man. Tore his freaking Achilles. That's a terrible injury. Damn Jets Field. Damn you, MetLife. Damn you. I found this very interesting that this happened today. Jaden Daniels, Drake May, and J.J. McCarthy are visiting the Commanders today and are expected to meet with Adam Peters and Dan Quinn, among others. Managing partner Josh Harris will also be in attendance as he continues to observe and support new Washington leadership. I mean, I think that's pretty interesting that they're going to bring in all three quarterbacks on the same day. I read Michael Penix that was brought in as well. I don't know why. I read that someone else reported that Michael Penix was also brought in. But it doesn't say it on this Ian Rappaport report. But, you know, I read that Michael Penix was also brought in. But even just bringing in the three of them, I find that so interesting. I don't feel like any other team has ever... Like, I can't remember a team in recent memory doing that. Bringing in three of the top quarterback prospects on, like, who they want on the same day. And, like, hey, which one of you are we drafting? I bet you they tell them which one... I gotta think they've made the decision by now, right? Like, it's gotta be, like, we're a week from the draft, basically. It's 9 days away. They have to have come to somewhat of a decision at this point. They had to have come up with some sort of decision at this point. No way they haven't, you know, they have to have the wheels kind of spinning in there. CJ Stroud on why Marvin Harrison should be the first wide receiver drafted.
I think I read something like he's NFL ready, but other guys... Why should it be Marv? Put on the tape. He's done it from
facts,
really
honestly. Put on the tape.
To now, when you talk about, I think I read something like he's NFL ready, but other guys have more potential. That makes no sense. Like, what? Like, if you're NFL ready, how is that not potential? You know, like, you want longevity. You want somebody who's been doing it. You know, and for him, that's what he sleeps, eats, and he breathes. You know,
facts. Marvin Harrison Jr. is nasty. Like, people don't like, dude, people don't like when I say this. People don't like when I say this, but bro, Malik Nabers is just as good as Marvin Harrison Jr. Sorry, just as good. Not gonna say better, but just as good. They're equal. They're so equal. Malik Nabers and Marvin Harrison Jr. are so equal, bro. So equal. I don't know, like, you get either one of them, you're happy as hell. Like, they're two of the best wide receiver prospects we've had since. They're better wide receiver prospects than Ja'Marr Chase, and that's, like, the only thing I can really compare them to. They're both better wide receiver prospects than Ja'Marr Chase. I love both of them. They're both nasty. I'll happily take either one on my fantasy team. Also part of the Washington Big Group is Houston Christian Edge Jalinks Hunt, who's also visiting with the Commanders today. Zion Johnson, bro, what a waste of a first-round pick, bro. Zion Johnson, no offense. Dude was kind of an L last year. San Francisco 49ers Brock Purdy saved a reporter from a coyote while doing a John Deere commercial. Here's what he said. Dude, I just saved a news anchor's life from being eaten by a coyote. He said this on the Pat McAfee Show. Is the video? Okay, the video's not there. It's probably somewhere further down. But, dude, why is Brock Purdy doing all of these, like, commercials for, like, farm shit? I saw him doing a commercial for, like, seeds. Like, seeds? I don't know why he was doing a commercial for seeds. Now he's doing a commercial for John Deere? Like, what is this he's trying to sell on us? The American Dream or something? What the fuck? What is this? I don't know. Odd. But, yeah. Brock Purdy doing John Deere commercials and saving reporters from coyotes. Gotta love it. Gotta love it, brother. Gotta love it. Oh, he's a farmer? Is that true? Is Brock Purdy a farmer? Brock Purdy's a farmer? Farmer Purdy? Farmer Purdy. The UFL's ratings are up 45% over last year's averages of the regular season. Yeah, but that's not fair. That's, like, you can't say that. Audio is glitching on Twitch. You're the only one saying that, my brother. You're the only one saying the audio is glitching. Oh, shit. Okay, everybody's saying the audio's glitching. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Let me unplug it. See what that does. Test, test, test. Test, test, test. Testy, test, test. Test, 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 test. Test, 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 test. Okay, yeah, I'm done. That's fine. Okay, that's fine. Okay, sorry. But hey, if you're on TikTok, you could go over to Twitch and hear me say test a lot. And you can see the news we're looking at. Go over to Twitch. Still bad? How's it bad? I don't know what could possibly be wrong with it. I don't know what could possibly be wrong with it. There's nothing we can fix right now. But, you say test like 30 times. Yeah, bro, we'd be saying test. But this is so... Okay, listen. This is so unfair. The UFL's ratings are up 45% over last year's averages. Like, okay, sure, they're up. But you combined two fucking leagues. You combined two leagues. Like, duh, they're gonna be up. You combined two leagues. It's still, no offense, I was supposed to watch the UFL games on Monday, and honestly, I just did not want to because it's just not fun to watch. I don't enjoy watching it. I'm sorry. I hate to, like, hate on the UFL because it's football, and, you know, it's good. It's getting people back in the game that, you know, aren't able to make it onto an NFL field. But, man, I just don't really like the UFL. I don't. It's just not entertaining to me. It's not quality football. It's mediocre football. I'm sorry, but that's the truth. It's mediocre football. Sorry. That's my opinion. Chris Greer told reporters that the team plans to pick up... Okay, I already talked about that. Who do we got winning tonight? Yo, who do we got winning the play-in tonight, ladies and gentlemen? Who we got winning tonight? Lakers? Pelicans? Lakers, Pelicans. Who we got? Lakers, Pelicans. Who we got? Lakers, Pelicans? Lakers? Lakers? Damn, bro. I want to take the Lakers, but I kind of want to see the Lakers lose. Not going to lie. I kind of want to see the Lakers lose, and I want to see the Dubs win so that we can see Lakers-Warriors fucking on Friday night. I think that'd be pretty sick. I wouldn't mind watching that, but Lakers-Warriors. Lakers, I mean, no, wait, what am I saying? Lakers-Pelicans. Who we got winning? Lakers-Pelicans. Let's see. Lakers, 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 Lakers. Lakers, 112-104, Pels, what's it on? I think it's on TNT. I think it's on TNT. It's always on TNT. It's always on TNT, I'm pretty sure. But I'm taking the Pelicans. I'm taking the Pelicans. You might want to fade me because I'm usually wrong. But hey, man, I'm taking the Pelicans. Yes, brother! I'm taking the Pelicans. And then I'm taking, ooh, Lakers-Warriors. Actually, I don't think the Warriors win tonight. I hate to say that. Like, who do we got? Warriors-Kings. Warriors-Kings, who do we got winning tonight? I don't think the Warriors win. I think the Kings win. I don't even think we get the opportunity to see Warriors-Lakers. I'd love to, but I think the Kings win. I think the Kings win. 10 p.m. I might go live. Should I go live? I obviously can't show the game because I'm not going to get banned again from TikTok Live. I don't want to do that. But should I go live maybe for the game? Maybe? I don't know. Maybe. Maybe I will. We'll see how I'm feeling. I'm not definitely not going live for Lakers Pelicans. Or maybe I'll go live for the end of it. I don't know. But I might go live for Warriors Warriors Kings. That's gonna be late though. That's gonna be late as hell. Late as hell. That's gonna be going on until like 1-2 in the morning for me. Sheesh. But yeah. I got Pelicans Kings. I got Pelicans Kings tonight. That's what I got. Pelicans Kings. Chiefs QB Patrick Mahomes says he will retire as soon as he feels like football is taking away from his family time. I want to be there for my daughters, is what he said. Dude's got two daughters. God bless, brother. God bless. God bless. God bless my guy. But Patrick Mahomes is kind of like a girl dad. I see that for him. I see that for him. I get that. I feel that for him. No stadium in the history of the NFL was louder than the Vikings after the Minneapolis. It doesn't mean turn the audio up, bro. That shit's peaking. Look at Mike Tyson run. Look at this. Look at this dude run. Why he run like that? That's how he sounds when he runs, bro. The fuck? The Dolphins will also pick up... Okay, yep. Yeah. Oh, dude, I saw this earlier. This made me so sad, bro. This made me sad. There is nothing imminent... This didn't even make the daily news. I forgot to talk about this. There is nothing imminent between the Miami Dolphins and free agent wide receiver OBJ. And you know who it came from? It didn't come from some NFL rumors source. It came from Chris Greer, the Miami Dolphins GM. He said there was no deal imminent between the Miami Dolphins and OBJ. Pretty sad. Pretty sad, man. I was really looking forward to that. But maybe we'll get somebody in the draft now. Maybe we'll look to get a wide receiver in the draft now. And that, I don't mind that. That'd be kind of cool, too. That'd be kind of sick. I wouldn't mind that either. There's a lot of good rookie wide receivers in this class. Wouldn't mind us grabbing one of them. A lot of Dolphins news, bro. A lot of Dolphins news. Kyle Pitts season is upon us. There's going to be a plan to get those guys all involved, particularly him. He'll be a focal point of what we want to do. That comes directly from Falcons head coach Raheem Morris. Directly from Raheem Morris. Okay, let me ask y'all a question. Where does Kyle Pitts finish this season, tight end wise? Where does he finish? Where does he finish? Top the tight end 1, tight end 2, tight end 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Where does he finish? And remember, Travis Kelce exists, Sam Laporta exists, George Kittle exists, Mark Andrews is going to be back. Who am I forgetting? I don't know. I'm forgetting people, though. 4, 4, 6. 4 is like a good answer. I think 4 or 5. 4 or 5 is a good answer. I think that's like a good safe place. But I'm not safe. I think Sam Laporta ends up being the 1. Nah, I mean, that was a rookie year thing. I don't know. Sam Laporta. Somewhere top 5. Travis Kelce's top 5. George Kittle. I think Kyle Pitts does better than George Kittle. Well, not if they trade Brandon Ayuk. That's interesting. That's something you got to watch. Brandon Ayuk gets traded. George Kittle's still a top 3 tight end at that point. So, I'd say Kyle Pitts is probably 5. Top 5, I'd say. Oh, Trey McBride's a sleeper pick, too. That's a good pick, Trey McBride, good answer. Trey McBride could be top 5 as well. Forgot about Trey McBride. Trey McBride will definitely be up there. Trey McBride will be balling this year. I'm not concerned about him at all. It's him and Marvin Harrison Jr. on the Cardinals. That's it. There ain't nothing else going on over there. Oh, look, here's the actual video of Brock Purdy talking about saving this reporter.
Unless you're just driving around a fucking tractor around San Francisco. You saved a reporter. A coyote was coming during a John Deere shoot.
You hear that?
A coyote started tracking down a local CBS reporter and her dog. And Brock Purdy, here's the video right here. It's a photo. They spell your name wrong on the right corner. Prudy's new gig.
Prudy's new gig.
Don't love that. Back on his tractor, but this lady right here, I watched this video this morning. She said, I just so happened.
Hilarious,
I just happened
bro.
Upon Brock Purdy and a couple offensive line.
Is there a video?
Know, coyote! I turned around. Biggest coyote I ever seen was stalking me and my dog or whatever. You saved the life. You saved the dog. You shot a John Deere tractor commercial in San Francisco. You're pick 262, leading a team to the Super Bowl in your second year. You're a magic man, Brock. Keep going, brother. We appreciate the hell out of you.
You know, it's hard. Like, people hate on him, but it's hard not to like Brock Purdy. Dude's an awesome guy. Freaking mystery relevant. Great story. You gotta love Brock Purdy. Gotta love the guy. Cool dude. Cool dude. So many wide receiver ones. Oh, baby. Here's a good question. Let me Google it real quick. Give me a second before I ask it. Before I ask this question. Okay. Let me ask y'all a question. What is going to end up being a better wide receiver draft class when it is all said and done? The 2024 NFL draft class? You know, Marvin Harrison, Malik Nabers, Rome Odunze, Brian Thomas Jr., Keon Coleman, Xavier Worthy, Adonai Mitchell, Ladd McConkey, Roman Wilson, or what's going to end up being a better draft class when it's all said and done? The 2024 class, or 10 years earlier, the 2014 class. I'm talking, let me get the names. I had them pulled up. 2014 class, you know, you got OBJ, Devontae Adams, Allen Robinson, Brandon Cooks, Jarvis Landry. This is not Mike Evans. This is not the career. I want more names. There's way more names in this class. Wait 1 minute. There's way more names in the 2014 class. Let me pull them up. Give me a second. Mike Evans, OBJ, Marquise Lee, Brandon Cooks, Jordan Matthews, Kelvin Benjamin, Jarvis Landry, Devontae Adams, Dante. I'm going to answer that question for myself. I think the 2024 draft class might be the best draft class of wide receivers ever in the history of the NFL. I don't even think. It might not even be a question. It's amazing. It's a great class. Now that I'm really thinking about it, I didn't really realize how deep it was until I just started listing all those names. This is probably going to go down as the best wide receiver class of all time. Wasn't there a recent wide receiver class that could rival it? Like maybe, what was the 2022 class? Drake London, Garrett Wilson, Chris Olave, J-Mo, Jahan Dotson. This is a better class than that. Yeah, dude. 2024. The 2024 class might be the best wide receiver class of all time. Not even close. Interesting. I never really thought about that. So yeah, 2024 class. I'm sorry. That was a stupid question. I shouldn't even asked. Oh my. Listen to this. Let's put the red glasses on. These ones are bent. Listen. New York Jets QB Aaron Rodgers says that HIV was created by the U.S. government. He says the game plan was made in the 80s. I know there's a video for that, actually. These are going to give me a headache, bro. These just make everything red. It's so weird. Oh, I don't like those. I don't like those glasses. But if you're if you're listening on TikTok, you should head over to Twitch at Tico Fantasy Show, at Tico Fantasy Show. Go over there, head over to Twitch, and follow. Get your name on this board behind me, and it's a much better view over there. I'm telling you. You get to see the news we're reading, and yeah, go over there. Go do that. Go see the Twitch. Go do that. Buccaneers are hosting safety Tykee Smith on a pre-draft visit today. Cool. I don't care. Oh, actually, here's the video.
Made in the 80s.
Here's the video. Let's listen to Aaron Rodgers spew some nonsense, ladies and gentlemen.
The game plan was made in the 80s. Create a pandemic, you know, with a virus that's going wild, right? Fauci was given like over $350 million to research this, to come up with drugs, new or repurposed, to handle the AIDS pandemic. And all they came up with was AZT. And if you do even a smidge of research, and I know I'm not a, you know, epidemiologist, I'm not a doctor, I'm not an immunologist, whatever the fuck. I can read though, right? And I can learn and look things up just like any normal person. You know, I can do my own research, which was so vilified, you know, to even question authority. But that was the game plan back then. Create an environment where only one thing works. Back then, AZT. Now, remdesivir until we get a vaccine. Which, by the way, Anthony Fauci had stake in the Moderna vaccine. And we know Pfizer is one of the most criminally corrupt organizations.
Correct me if I'm wrong here, but there's no cure for HIV, right? They haven't come up with that, right? That's not a thing yet, right? They haven't solved that problem, right? They haven't solved that issue, right? Not laughing. That's not funny. That's a serious disease. But they haven't figured out the cure for that, right? I don't think so. I don't think they figured out the cure for HIV yet, so I don't know what he's talking about. I guess he's talking about COVID now. I don't know, man. Aaron Rodgers, though, claims that the U.S. government created HIV. W. Aaron Rodgers, I guess. No, well, not W, actually. That's not W. Aaron Rodgers. Aaron Rodgers is off one, actually. The ayahuasca doing crazy things. Phoenix Suns head coach, Falcons head coach, Taylor Decker. Who was the best NFL draft prospect ever? Give me some answers. Who was the best NFL draft prospect ever? Hey, your birthday's on the draft? Well, freaking nice. Cool. Best NFL draft prospect ever? Antonio Brown. Andrew Luck. Andrew Luck is up there. Andrew Luck is for sure up there. Andrew Luck is 100% up there. Probably one of the best prospects ever. I'm trying to think who else was up there. best draft prospects ever. All time. Best draft prospects ever. Trevor Lawrence was a great prospect, but not like Andrew Luck level. Joe Burrow was a better prospect than Trevor Lawrence. I don't know. I'm trying to think. I don't really have an answer for that question. Caleb Williams. Caleb Williams is going to be up there, you know. Caleb Williams is one of the best draft prospects ever. But this guy's saying, like, he's saying Calvin Johnson. I don't know. Andrew Luck is probably the right. Oh, AP? AP's a good answer. No, y'all are giving... These are stupid. Okay, let me keep scrolling here. Ooh, here we go. Here's a fun one. Start, bench, cut. DJ Moore, Deebo Samuel, Nico Collins. Start, bench, cut. I have my answer. Assuming that Brandon Ayuk is not traded and Brandon Ayuk is on the Niners next year. Assume that. Like, don't forget about that. Start, bench, cut. DJ Moore, Deebo Samuel, Nico Collins. Let's see. Start Nico, start DJ, bench Nico, cut Deebo, bench Nico. Dude, this is right. Bench Nico, cut Nico. Cut Deebo. Yo, I'll review the Drake diss at the end of the stream, actually. Like, oh, we're getting close to the end of the stream already. Damn, we're already 55 minutes in. Start DJ, bench Nico, cut. Okay, so my answer. Okay, first of all, we're doing it backwards. I'm cutting Deebo. Because I'm not thinking, like, talent here. I'm thinking, like, fantasy football. That's how I'm thinking right now, fantasy-wise. So, Deebo, I'm cutting Deebo. Benching? Call me a madman, but I'm benching Nico Collins. I'm benching Nico Collins, and I'm starting DJ Moore. I don't know if that's the consensus, but I'm starting DJ Moore because, bro, I understand that they're going to have Keenan Allen, and Keenan Allen's going to obviously take away some from DJ Moore, but I don't think he's going to take away that much, and I think Caleb Williams is going to bring a lot more passing, you know, a lot more work into that offense, a lot more, you know, I think they're going to be a lot more of a pass-heavy team with Caleb there, and DJ Moore's gross. DJ Moore's gross, and Keenan Allen being there might actually help him. Keenan Allen being there might actually help him more than hurt him, because you have another guy taking away coverage, kind of like what happened this past year with CeeDee Lamb and Brandon Cooks. Just saying. I love DJ Moore. I think DJ Moore's gross. I just love DJ Moore. I think he's kind of just like Debo, but, you know, a little smaller, a little younger. DJ Moore doesn't age. DJ Moore's probably 26 years old still. Let's see. How old is DJ Moore? How old is DJ Moore? How old do you think DJ Moore is? Oh, he's 27. But just turned 27. He just got old, bro. DJ Moore just got old. Took him a very long time to get there. It took him years to get old. Damn. I feel like DJ Moore was like 24 years old forever. He turned 27 on April 14th, I think it was. Yeah, April 14th. Oh. That was 2 days ago. Happy birthday, DJ Moore. Happy late birthday, DJ Moore. That was 2 days ago. Happy birthday, guy. Oh, this was kind of sad. This is in NFL news, but this is kind of sad. Blake Griffin is retiring. I mean, I understand he's not really that good anymore. He's really not that good anymore, but still. I miss Blake Griffin. I remember the good old days. I remember the good old, freaking Clippers, Blake Griffin, dunk contest days. Oh, jumping over cars. Those were the good old days. The good old days. That's back when I watched basketball religiously. But, yeah. Bye, Blake Griffin. Good career. Did he get a... I don't think he ever got a ring, did he? I don't think he ever got a ring. Never got a ring, did he? Nope. Never got a ring. Tough, buddy. Tough, buddy. That's tough. 13-year career, though. That's a long career. Patrick Mahomes says he's nowhere near GOAT status yet, but that he has a top three start to his career. I think he probably has the number one start to his career, I would say. I don't think that's a hot take at all. Top three? But it's hard to take away from what Tom Brady or what Peyton Manning did or Aaron Rodgers. There's so many guys that's at a high level. You can't... I would say Patrick Mahomes probably so far in his career has the best start to any NFL player ever so far to the start of his career. And I think when it's all said and done, Patrick Mahomes will be the undisputed GOAT. Even if he lost to Tom Brady one time or two times, however many times it was. Actually, it was two times. It was a Super Bowl and the AFC Championship. I don't care. Patrick Mahomes couldn't win with that team. That team was garbage that they gave Patrick Mahomes. That I remember that Super Bowl, bro. Patrick Mahomes was freaking doing everything. He could not, like, you can't win a football game by yourself. I'm sorry, but you can't. That's how it goes. So, Patrick Mahomes will go down in history as the GOAT, my opinion. Aaron Rodgers talking about HIV some more. This is interesting. The Eagles now have the fourth highest paid quarterback, the fourth highest paid running back, the fourth highest paid wide receiver, the fifth highest paid wide receiver, the fifth highest paid tight end, the fourth highest paid offensive lineman, the fifth highest paid offensive lineman, and the highest paid offensive guard. That is the most expensive, that's got to be the most expensive offense in the league. Plus they got all those rookies on defense. They're really... I think it's the year, bro. I think it's the Eagles, bro. I think we got Eagles, Texans, Super Bowl this year. I think we got Eagles, Texans, Super Bowl this year. That's where I'm going. And that aligns with the Super Bowl colors. That aligns with the Super Bowl logo colors. It aligns. It works. Commanders are hosting QB Cortland Sutton. What is this? 24 years ago, this is the pick.
Man, Tom Brady, the quarterback.
Look how young he is,
who,
bro.
All he did was lead this football team, put them in the right position more times than not. And when he got pulled from the game, and Drew Henson came in,
I love watching
Michigan
OG
football,
like I love watching OG
was.
Like
no,
Brady.
Was no question, like smart experiences.
Look, this is not even. It's not rectangular. It's freaking square. It's in that 3-4 aspect ratio because freaking that's how the TVs were back then. That's sick. What is this? Former college basketball player Brian Matos. More about the three of them. Oh, here's what I was talking about earlier. We have heard rumblings that Nick Chubb will not be ready until late November for a potential return. This makes it more clear why he took a nearly $10 million pay cut. Yeah, that does make a lot more sense. That does make a lot more sense. Yeah. What's his, how much does Nick Chubb get? I tried to Google this. Oh, I tried to Google this last time and it wouldn't let me. It wasn't updated yet, but let's see what Nick Chubb's contract currently looks like. Out of curiosity, I want to see what he's supposed to get. Okay, so look, Nick Chubb was previously supposed to get paid like $13 million this year. Now, he's only getting paid 2.2. He's getting paid $2.2 million this year with a $6 million cap hit. Yeah, 2.2. That's a fat, oh my God. That is a fat demotion. Contract, I don't know. I don't know, but that's a lot of money. That's $10 million down the hole. That's $10 million Rashee Rice could be using to pay for freaking lawsuits. Garrett Wilson's in Cleveland. Garrett Wilson said he loves Cleveland. We're 9 days away from the NFL draft, people. 9 days away. 9 days away from the NFL draft. We're streaming it. We're streaming the entire draft on TikTok, on Twitch. We're streaming it. Twitch, watch this real quick. What was that? NFL news. We're doing some NFL news. And yeah, go over there to Twitch. Go over there. Go follow. Okay, let's keep going. We're almost done here. We're an hour in already. God damn. Okay. Chiefs QB Patrick Mahomes says he hopes to play in spring training for the Kansas City Royals one of these years. Okay, that's stupid. That's really stupid, my brother. Giannis, this is not NFL news, but Giannis news. The Milwaukee Bucks are preparing to be without two-time MVP Giannis Antetokounmpo for the start of their opening round series against the Indiana Pacers, but her hopeful treatment on his left calf strain will allow him to return sometime later in the series. Oh, okay. So they won't lose him for the entire series. That's actually good. That's W. That's, like, nice. That's good for them. That's okay. They won't lose him for the entire thing. That's good. Very good. We like to see that. That's good. Cortland Sutton doesn't report for voluntary OTAs. Happy birthday to the greatest coach. Hey, today's Bill Belichick's birthday. Happy birthday, Bill Belichick. Happy birthday. Six-time Super Bowl champion, Bill Belichick. Cortland Sutton, and we're starting to get into tomorrow's news. Yeah. Okay, we're about to get into tomorrow's news. Yeah. Oh, well, this is not tomorrow's news. Unless they can land a massive haul to move down, the Falcons are locked in on edge rusher Dallas Turner. My boy Dallas, going to Atlanta. That's what's happening. It's happening, I'm telling you. I love that. I love that for them. They need edge. That's the perfect guy for them. If Dallas Turner is there at 8, I will bet all my money that they take him. I will bet everything that they take him. I love Dallas Turner. Dude's gross. Patrick Mahomes made it on the Time Magazine. A lot of Patrick Mahomes news today. And yeah, now we're into yesterday's news. Let me refresh this, see if there's anything new that happened. Chiefs tight end Travis Kelce will host the Are You Smarter Than a Celebrity game show on Amazon Prime. I'm not watching it. I'm not watching it. Maybe you will. I ain't watching it, though. Yeah. But yeah, that's it. That's all we got for NFL news. Real quick. Let's listen to this real quick. Is it not on YouTube? Is this it? Oh.
I could never be nobody number one fan. Your first number one, I had to put it in your hand. You pussies can't get booked outside America for Nan. I'm out in Tokyo because I'm big in Japan. I'm the hit maker y'all depend on. Backstage in my
city. Is that the diss? Wait a minute. Let me just go on Twitter and look it up, actually. That's going to be so much easier. Wait. Oh, wait, no, wait, Drake. Oh, well, wait a minute. That's not gonna... Let me not do that. Let me not type that in. That's not gonna go well. I almost typed in Drake leak on Twitch. That's funny. Okay, here we go. Okay, push up.
I'm a hit maker, y'all depend on. Backstage in my city, it was friend zone. You won't never take no chain off.
We're listening to the Drake diss real quick. And then I'm gonna end the stream.
Never be nobody number one fan. Your first number one, I had to put it in your hand. You pussies can't get booked outside America for Nan. I'm out in Tokyo because I'm big in Japan. I'm the hit maker, y'all depend on. Backstage in my city, it was friend zone. You won't ever take no chain off of us. How the fuck you big stepping with a size 7 man zone? This the part with the bite, nigga, what's up? I know my picture on the wall when y'all cook up. Extortion, baby, whole career, you been shook up. Cause Top told you drop it, give me 50 likes or push-ups. Hood, your last one brick, you really not on shit. They make excuses for you cause they hate to see me lit. Pull your contract cause we gotta see the split. The way you doing splits, bitch, your pants might rip. You better do that motherfucking show inside the bitty. Maroon 5 need a verse, you better make it witty. Then we need a verse for the Swifties. Top say drop, you better drop and give them 50. Pip squeak pipe down, you ain't in no big three. Scissor got you wiped down, Travis got you wiped down, Savage got you wiped down. Like your label, boy, you in a scope right now. And you gon' feel the aftermath of what I write down. I'm at the top of the mountain, so you tight now. Just to add this talk with your ass, I had to hike down. Big difference between Mike then and Mike now. What the fuck is this, a 20v1, nigga? What's a prince to a king? He a son, nigga. Get more love in the city that you from, nigga. Metro, shut your whole ass up and make some drums, nigga. Yeah, I'm the sixth god, I'm the front runner. Y'all nigga manager was Charles' little blunt runner. Clean a six and you boys ain't even come from it. And when you boys got rich, you had to run from it. Cash blowing, able bread out here tricking. Shit we do for bitches, he doing for niggas. Jets, whips, chains, wicked, wicked, wicked.
Yo, that's crazy, like actually. Wait a minute, fuck, that's boy, crazy.
Cash blowing, able bread out here tricking. Shit we do for bitches, he doing for niggas. Jets, whips, chains, wicked, wicked, wicked. Boys ain't even come from bread out here tricking. Shit we do for bitches, he doing for niggas. Jets, whips, chains, wicked, wicked.
That's
wicked.
Crazy, bro.
Spinning like you tryna fuck, boy, you tripping, boy, you tripping. Drizzy Chippendale, probably got your bitch in nail. I just got them done, boy, don't make me at the Chippendale. Rolling loud stage, y'all would turn, that was slick as hell. Shit'll probably change if your BM start to kiss and tear. Hugs and kisses, man, don't tell me about no switches. I be rocking every fucking chain I own next busy, ayy. I be with some bodyguards like Whitney. Top say drop your little midget ass, better fucking, ayy. Better drop and give me 50, ayy. Drop and give me 50, drop and give me 50, ayy. Niggas really got me out here talking like I'm 50. Niggas really got me out here rapping what I'm living. I might take your latest girl and cuff her like I'm Ricky. Can't believe he jumping in, this nigga turning 50. Every song that made it on the chart he got from Drizzy. Spend that little check, you gotta stay up out my business. Nigga, shout out to the hooper that be busting out the gritty. We know why you mad, nigga, I ain't even tripping. All that little heartbroken Twitter shit for bitches. This for all the top dogs, drop and give me 50, drop, drop. In that fucking song, y'all got to not start the beef with us. This shit been brewing in a pot, now I'm heating up. I don't care what Cole think, that dot shit was weak as fuck. Champagne tripping, he is not fucking easing up. Nigga calling Top to see if Top wanna piece it up. Top wanna piece it up, Top wanna piece it up. Nah, pussy, now you on your own when you speaking up. You done roll deep to this, it's not fucking deep enough. Begging cops or not, boy, you not fucking beating us. Numbers wise, I'm out of here, you not fucking creeping up. Money wise, I'm out of here, you not fucking sneaking up. Cornball, your show. Money, merch money, feed us. I'ma let you niggas work it out because I seen enough. This ain't even everything I know, don't wait the demon up. This ain't even everything I know, don't wait the demon up. Drop and give me 50, all you fuck niggas teaming up.
What the fuck are you smoking on, Kendrick?
Yeah, drop a 50 bag for the mob in a spot. Drop a 50 bag, 29 for the thought. I would really, really try to keep it PG.
J. Cole is not even in the conversation anymore. I need to hear Kendrick's response to this shit. I need to hear Kendrick's response to this shit. That's what I need to hear. Kendrick didn't respond on frickin'... I was ready for a Kendrick response on We Still Don't Trust You. No response, didn't get anything. So I need a Kendrick response. That's what I gotta say. I need a Kendrick response. Right now, bruh, J. Cole's like sitting in, J. Cole's not even in his beef anymore, bruh. J. Cole bitched out. I'm kinda pissed about that J. Cole did that. J. Cole kinda bitched out on the beef. But Drake's sitting up top. That's all I gotta say about Drake. Drake's up there. We're all down here. Drake's on a different world. Always has been, always will be. Mr. Drake. We love Aubrey. Okay. That's all I got for today. Thank you very much for watching on TikTok. I'm ending over there. If you want to keep watching, head on over to Twitch at Tico Fantasy Show. At Tico Fantasy Show. Head on over there. Follow. Get your name on this board behind me. And yeah, have yourself a wonderful day. Okay. So yeah. Okay, Twitch people, I'm ending stream. We're going to go back to the one shot for a second. I'm ending stream. Oh, wait, no, I'm not. I have to write names on the board. What am I doing? I have to write names on the board. I totally forgot about that shit. My bad. Totally forgot I got to write names on the board. Forgot about that entirely. I gotta pull it up. Okay, here we go. Let's write some names. Let's write some names on the stream. Okay, let me write some names. Oh! Okay. We got, oh, you Maddie? Oh, you Maddie, the finisher. They love. Ditto. Cubs Hawk. Steven only. Brave twin. TF Austin. Zimbo Slice. Dill Pickle. The one true God Toaster? Digillo Silos? Pat Mahomey? Look at this board, bro. We're filling this board up. Hunter? And MTF Slacks. Okay, everybody's name is on the board. Everybody's name is on the board. Look at this board, bro. We're filling the board up. We're almost full. The board's gonna be full soon. The board's gonna be full soon. Oh no, did somebody else follow? Wait a minute, I'll check, brother. Refresh followers. What do you mean refresh? I think I wrote them all. Did I not write them all? NWA the best. I think I already wrote you, brother. Did I not? Okay. Yeah. I think we're done, ladies and gentlemen. We're done. That's all we got for today. Thank you very much for watching. We'll be back tomorrow at 4:30. And before I go, listen, watch this real quick. Bam.